Member for Alberni Pacific Rim.
The Premier appointed Grand Chief Ed John as her advisor on Aboriginal children in care. He's a man well known to British Columbians and respected by all in this house. On October the 6th, Grand Chief Ed John and the First Nations Leadership Council called on the Premier to launch an independent investigation, an inquiry into the death of Alex Gervais. Honourable Speaker, it's pretty clear that the Premier has stopped listening, certainly, to the families of children like Nick and Carly who are asking for investigations. But will the Premier, how is she going to respond to that same request from her own respected advisor?
Minister for Children and Family Development.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And as the member knows, this ministry has a number of processes and policies and external mechanisms in place to provide scrutiny and oversight. That is essential in a ministry that is doing the work with vulnerable children in the province, and we welcome that oversight, and it is vast, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, the appointment of Grand Chief Ed John as a special advisor to me is an example of our commitment to working with First Nations peoples to improve the outcomes for children and youth in this province. Chief Ed John and I share a commitment to that work. We share an understanding that work can only be successful when we work directly with First Nations communities and hear from them about how best to achieve that work, and that is what we're going to do together.
Alberni Pacific Rim on a supplemental.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. I'm not questioning Grand Chief Ed John's commitment. I'd like to quote from his letter, as a matter of fact. "We are extremely concerned that the Premier's inflammatory comments to the media blaming a delegated agency have negatively impacted the whole bureaucracy's ability to assess Alex Gervais' death. Further," he says, "when the ministry fails to protect children from harm, the Premier defends social workers in superior courts. When a delegated agency fails to protect children from harm, she vows consequences." Honourable Speaker, given these comments from her own advisor, will the Premier call for an independent inquiry?
Minister for Children and Family Development.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And as we've spoken about numerous times in this House, there are policies in place when there is a death of a child in care. In the case of a tragedy like this, the Provincial Director of Child Welfare has the authority and responsibility to conduct a review. A review is underway into the case specified. When that review is complete, it is forwarded to the independent representative for children and youth, at which point, if the representative feels it is required, can launch an investigation of her own.